Amidst the beautiful locales of Northeast India lies a dirty truth. It remains largely unreported. The region is marred with cross-border human trafficking. Many young girls fall prey to this crime and are never able to return to their homes.
वहाँ पे तो सैलरी अच्छा है क्योंकि घर में कुछ काम भी नहीं कर रहे ना हम लोग, इसलिए क्या सैलरी 30,000 ऐसा मैंने तो क्या हम लोग भी हो रहा था।
L. Simte, father of Esther, is a worried man. Esther had left in April 2017 and was out of touch for about 8 months. She contacted the family only in December 2017.
My daughter made a call to me, but due to network problem, we could not talk in detail. She said that she had reached Singapore and after that the line cut off and we couldn't talk.
Unregistered placement agencies in Manipur and Mizoram supply young girls to Southeast Asian and Gulf countries. A local agent identifies the girls and lures them in the name of employment to work as a housemaid or babysitter with good food and lodging in Singapore, Thailand or China. These girls are supplied for various kinds of work, including domestic and sex work. The girls are taken through the porous borders to Myanmar and are given a Myanmar passport. Their Indian identity documents are confiscated once they reach Myanmar. Essentially, the agents make sure that they leave no identity trail. And once the girls cross over, they get trapped with no way of returning home.
The girls are divided into two. These two groups are the beautiful one and the ugly ones. So the ugly ones are kept somewhere, the beautiful ones are separated. We don't know how their living condition would be that side, the beautiful and the ugly. So in that way they spend their life there. And it's very hard to come back to India again. Where did all these girls from Singapore come to this Singapore? It's very shameful. There are many girls who are doing different kinds of work. When you say shameful, means not, I think it's very difficult to explain.
Somewhere you think they end up being sex slaves or end up being in the flesh trade in these countries? Is I mean, do you fear that for them?
Since according to the division, somehow I fear because they are separating the beautiful and the ugly.
There are three sets of agents. The Indian agent picks the girls late at night and delivers them at the Myanmar border. The Myanmar agent then takes the girl to the headquarters in Yangon. The Singapore agent confiscates the Myanmar passport. From Mizoram, the girls are usually taken from Zokhaw Thar village in Champai district on the Indo-Myanmar border. From Manipur, they are usually taken from Moray, a small market town in the Indian territory, to Tamo in Myanmar. They can just cross over on foot or a two-wheeler without being noticed.
According to the interview done by the child, they said that they don't take us 4, 5, 6 at one time. They took 3 at one time, they dropped that side, they'll come back again, take another 3. So that the police and someone do not have any suspicion.
Okay.
So in that way they do. And then when they reach to cross Burma, they have to make another passport, fake passport. Burma, they have one. The agent have for one hostel, a very big room, where they are kept there, given training, the way how they should serve in Singapore, they give all those training. Then after that, they'll make another passport so that they can move to Singapore.
To get the Myanmari passport, the girls are taught the Burmese language in the hostel. 17-year-old Mercy from Mizoram was found dead in Singapore under mysterious circumstances. And to her parents' horror, she no longer had an Indian passport. All she had was Myanmar passport with a completely different identity. There was no way to even bring her body back to India. Mercy's family does not want to file a complaint. They say this will not bring their daughter back. The anti-human trafficking unit in Mizoram has no registered cross-border trafficking case.
From our observation, I think this has been happening since 2013-14.
Everybody is very much aware, it seems, but nobody wants to
talk about it.
Talk about it, it seems. Because of the social status and something like this. Social status means because they will get bad names and all these things, something like that.
Esther's father is a rare example of a case filed with the police in Churchandpur. According to H.N. Haukip, Secretary, Center for Women and Girls, more than 90% cases are not reported in the region.
It's also because of the local governance systems, like in the hills or tribals, we have our own governance systems, like customary law, it's deciding, it's a kind of a justice system, it's the customary law. The stigma that is associated with the victim, whoever is returning, I think this is one of the main factors that people don't want to speak out. More than 50 years, because of the APSPA, the conflict, and also specific to the ethnic violent conflict and other armed conflicts 20 years back, you know, many people of our district, there was a mass internal displacement, and their livelihood depends on the chum cultivation. They don't have source of income, and when they don't have regular occupation, that is one. And also lack of educational institutions. It's one very big issue in the hill, because children has to stay away from their parents. Then they become a soft target.
12 girls were rescued from Yangon. They narrated that there were 50 girls and not allowed to go out or even stand at the window. The agent gave them some money for toiletries, and when they needed something, they had to request the dormitory staff to bring it for them. After the rescue, they were sent back to India. They were lucky.
The conviction rate is very less. Even that the law enforcement and the government knows who are the traffickers and the recruited agencies. But the giving the conviction rate is very less. That is why the traffickers and the recruitment agency, they are very easily, again and again, repeatedly, they traffic the children and the women and the girls from Manipur.
India still awaits the cabinet approval for a comprehensive anti-human trafficking bill. The lives of young girls in the Northeast remain in danger.